Yeah, so another pair of crossbred gilts we have in here. The Belta gilt is 23-5. The calico would be another 24 to litter. She'd be 24-4. 24-4, that would be an in-game, back on a capone, next contestant. Those females, I guess, in terms of sow-wise, have been done an incredible job. That's her first litter. You would have saw some of them males and another litter mate gilt earlier that was very high quality. I think that one falls in right there with them in terms of just bone and stoutness, yet flexible. I think that one, once she gets on the feed bucket, I'd say it would be very, very hard to get around, just depending on, you know, where she lands and you know, who's on the stick. But I think regardless, that's going to be a very high quality kind of a crossbred female. The 23 litter gilt is the black belted one. Ride With Me Capone would be her pedigree. One that's probably a little more immature compared to her mates that you maybe have seen earlier that we would have previewed. But another one, I think, just in terms of quality and what that Ride With Me pig's done for us has done an incredible job, just in terms of look and design from the side and stoutness going and coming. So good pair of gilts. We're winding this thing down on the preview side of thing in terms of crossbreds, but I think this pair of gilts is very nice as well.
Yeah, Jared, and the 24 litters is one that I commented earlier that there was an only litter mate barrel that was in there, and it was the only litter mate. They lied to me. They brought me a calico here that's a litter mate to one of them that I commented earlier was the only one, and when it comes to color, there's no doubt. I mean, I don't think I need to tell anybody that's listening. There's no doubt I'm a sucker for a calico, and this here gilt is no exception to the rule when it comes to calico. If you don't like the color, don't bid on her. But I'm going to tell you what: if you don't like the color, don't complain, don't whine when you get beat by her, because those calicos like that, they stick out in the ring, and with a little sun, will get darker. I like that gilt awful well. I remember the Barra a while ago that was a litter mate that I liked awful, awful well, that I said was the only one in the litter, and I was wrong. They do have another one here, and this one here is very, very good. Tail root, one stout-headed, good scald. Square made. I like those kind. Those kind right there, in my opinion, in my barn and with my girls, they have always showed something different. And if you want to show something different and follow the same path that I have been on for many, many years, you better pay attention right here, because this one right here has the right look and right bone, hair, skull shape, squareness, toe spread that you need to have. I'd like to give you excuses for the gilt for her color, but I've got a couple of them at home that no one has bought, and I wonder why, and I think sometimes it's because of their color. But wait till this summer. When they hit the ring this summer and you like them, don't complain about them. That gilt right there is awful, awful good. And do not overlook her. Check out her tightness of throat latch, her body shape. When you get tightness of throat latch and body shape like that, with a hock, with a toe spread, with a hind leg and hock shape like that, it don't matter what color they are. I like that gilt awful, awful well. The black gilt, the thin belt gilt right here, maybe just a pinch greener in her makeup. But like I've said before, green is not a quality trait. And that one right there, for as green as she is, you look at the spread in her chest and the base of her chest and the square, her squareness of knee and her look, her bone. Her bone is unbelievable compared to one that has that. I mean, her bone in comparison to her body shape and greenness is unreal. I mean, and you can see it right there. She is way, way, way good looking. Her body shape is immature. And I'm not going to make excuses for her body shape being immature, because their body shape is only in a feed bucket. A feed bucket is what wins a show. And so you better study your lesson there and look at that guilt, because her bone is unreal. Her hair is good. Her squareness of pins is good. She's freak-necked. She's square-chested. She's square-bodied. I like that guilt awful well. I know we're getting towards the end of our preview right here. And at times we get tired. Let's just say that. Let's just be honest. We get tired. But check out that guilt. Mm-hmm. Huh? Hey, you're so tired, you don't say much.
Yeah, right. No, it's a good set of pigs, I think. And as you said, I think that one, just once she matures and kind of comes, that one's gonna be a handful. Those Ride Me Pigs have done well for us, and I have a lot of confidence here.